this will be interesting because I don't. I know about two events.
Thank you.
Okay.
So actually.
Hello everyone. Today we are with Fletcher, and we will be talking about rodeo. Is this your first time in Poland?
No, it's actually my second time in Poland.
What do you like most about Poland?
I really like y'all's food with pierogies and just the potato-based foods and the history that y'all have here. Y'all have some beautiful buildings that we don't just because of y'all's history.
I heard that you're a cowboy. Is that true?
I don't know about a cowboy. I have competed in some of their sporting events, as in bull riding and bareback riding, but I would not call myself a cowboy.
What would you call yourself?
I would call myself a rodeo athlete, not a cowboy.
How many competitions did you take part?
I don't know. That's a hard question because I've competed in so many over the years. It's hundreds of competitions that I've been a part of. I don't know an exact number.
How many years have you been in rodeo?
I started when I was 17 and went on until about 21, so about 4 or 5 years in rodeo.
It's pretty long.
Yeah, I abused my body pretty badly in that time.
So why did you stop?
I had to stop rodeoing due to injuries. I've had 5 knee surgeries on my left knee now due to riding bulls and getting on broncs.
What's the bronc?
A bronc is what we call a horse that bucks.
What's bucks?
Where it kicks and jumps up in the air and tries to knock the person off.
When did you start rodeoing?
Rodeoing in America is kind of a family tradition sport. So if your parents or anyone else in your family has done it, you kind of follow in the footsteps of doing it. So my grandfather was a bull rider. My dad was a bronc rider and bull rider. So when I got old enough, I started competing as well.
What's your favorite event?
So my favorite event is the bull riding. In bull riding, you're getting on this bull and you have to stay on it for at least 8 seconds. And if you don't stay on for at least 8 seconds, then you don't get a score. And in the bull riding, you get scored on 2 things. You get scored on how well you ride the bull, and you also get scored on how well the bull bucks, so how well it jumps up in the air and how well it tries to throw you off. So the better the bull, the better the score. And the better you ride it, the better the score.
What happened when you fall off of the bull before 8 seconds?
If you fall off or get bucked off the bull before 8 seconds, you will have no score and you won't have a score and you won't have the capability of winning anything, and it's just pretty much a waste of time at that point.
You train a lot for a sport event that lasts 8 seconds.
Yes, so we train quite a bit. We lift weights, we run, and the reasoning for these things is to make sure that our bodies are taken care of well enough so when we do get bucked off or we get hit by the bull, to prevent injury. Also, the 8 seconds that you're on that takes a lot more out of your body than people realize. It takes a lot of energy, and so running helps build up stamina and things of that nature to help us not get as tired when we're on there.
Do girls ride a bull?
There are some that do ride bulls. They do not ride at a professional level, but there are some, and I've been to some rodeos where I've seen girls get on bulls.
You said professional. Did you get money for riding a bull?
Yes. So I only competed in a couple of professional rodeos. But in rodeo, it's a little bit different than most sports. From the time that you start rodeoing at a young age, if you win your event, then you get paid as a kid.
As a kid?
As a child.
As a child.
You could make money in rodeo today.
Yeah, I started, as soon as I started riding, you make money. So Patrick, have you ever seen a rodeo?
No, I haven't.
What do you think about rodeo from what I've told you?
I think it's really great fun, but very dangerous.
Would you ever consider competing in a rodeo?
I would be afraid to do it.
I understand. I was afraid a lot too.
A dobrze powiedziałem? A, bo trochę zmieniłem zdanie.